What's up guys? I'm Engineer Jack. So for today's video guys, pag-usapan naman natin yung strength of materials or pag-usapan natin yung course overview of this subject. So first, let us define a mechanics. So mechanics is the science that describes and predicts the conditions of rest or motion of bodies under the action of forces. So ano bang behavior ng bodies natin when it is acted upon by forces? So we have different types of mechanics. So first type of mechanic is we have the mechanics of rigid bodies. Another type of mechanics is we have mechanics of materials, or ito na mismo yung strength of materials. And another type of mechanics is mechanics of fluids. So yung mechanics of fluids, pinag-aaralan dyan yung behavior of a fluid under the action of forces. So sa mechanics of rigid bodies, we have different types din dyan. So yung different types of rigid bodies natin, we have statics of rigid bodies and dynamics of rigid bodies. So for statics, stable pa din siya or static siya, so at rest siya or walang motion. But for dynamics naman, di dyan naman natin inaaral yung behavior of rigid bodies natin in motion naman. So that is the different types of mechanics. So ano bang ibig sabihin ng mechanics of materials or strength of materials? So mechanics of materials or strength of materials is a branch of mechanics that studies the internal effects of stress and strain in a solid body. So for example, mag-apply ako ng load in a body. For example, that is a steel material, and if it's acted by a force, so let's say, lagay ako ng force at the top and ipupull ko yan. So nagbigay ako ng tension force. So in this subject kasi, maaaral natin dito na yung behavior of our bodies under the action of forces, we can have a deformation of that body. So in this case, kung yung tension yung force na nilagay natin sa body, magkakaroon tayo ng deformation. And this deformation is what we called elongation. Kumbaga, humaba yung material natin because of tension force. And yan yung, basically, yan yung aaralin natin dito sa mechanics of materials or strength of materials. So, ano ba yung behavior ng material natin when it is acted by upon by forces? So, this time, unlike sa statics kasi, inaaral dito yung deformation or yung deformable body natin. Kasi sa rigid bodies kasi or statics, kinukonsider yung body as rigid talaga or undeformable. So, walang deformation doon. Yung stress kasi is associated with the strength of material from which the body is made. So, very important yung stress topic natin dito sa strength material kasi doon natin malalaman kung ano ba yung strength of any material. And another term dito na kailangan natin isaulo is yung strain. Kasi yung strain, this is a measure of the deformation of the body. So in this case, for this example, as you can see in the figure, this deformation, yung hinaba niya all over the original length, actually that is the measure of the deformation or strain na tinatawag. So yan basically yung aaralin natin dito sa strength of materials. So nag-iikot lang yan sa dalawa, which is yung stresses and deformation niya or strain in our body. So, ano ba yung importance of this subject or yung mechanics of materials? So, it has a vital importance in the design of machines, and syempre, sa civil engineering, we have structures. So, for example, meron tayong columns here na meron tayong foundation, and syempre, lagay tayo ng beams din and a truss or for our roofing material. So for this case, let's say kukunin ko guys yung truss natin just like in our statics. Na alam natin yung truss members of our trusses, mayroon diyang internal forces din na dinadala. So dito sa strength of material, very important itong topic or subject kasi we need to get the values for our forces and stresses. So, saan ba galing yung mga forces natin in our structure? So, syempre, from the weight itself or own weight of that structure and yung dadalhin niya. For example, yung tao na mag-occupy ng structure na yan or all materials na naka-fixed to that structure. For example, lahat ng ceilings natin, lahat ng nakadikit sa structure natin, lahat ng mismong own weight of our structure, and lahat ng moving loads. Kumbaga, just like in our structural theory, that is live loads and dead loads. So, in order to solve the forces, yun yung kailangan natin yung own weight na yun. And for to solve the stresses, we need this subject na mechanics of materials. And bakit kailangan natin yung stresses? Kasi in structural design, we need to solve the size and kung ano ba yung material na gagamitin natin na the best option for our structure. Kasi in our structures, we have different materials that we can use to create a structure. So sometimes meron tayong ginagamit na reinforced concrete, or minsan steel design, or minsan wood or timber design. So with different approach, with different materials and sizes, we can design a structure in structural engineering. So that's why this subject is very important in designing our structures. So next we have also for beams. So these are horizontal members for our structure. So these are members na naka-horizontal. So we need this subject then to solve the internal forces in our members, and to solve the forces, the stresses pa din, to solve the size and best material that we can use for our material. And same case for our columns. So we need also the values for forces and stresses, and to solve the size and best material for our structure. So basically, yan lang naman yung paikot-ikot natin sa design. That's why we sa structural engineering, we need mathematics, we need the statics of rigid bodies na subject. We need also the mechanics of materials, and we need also the structural theory or structural analysis in order to design a structure in structural design. So that's the basics. Actually, dito umiikot yung structural engineering natin. So for these members actually in our structure or in this subject, our formulas and rules of design cited in engineering codes are based upon the principles of this subject. Kaya very important itong subject kasi dito nagbe-base yung mga engineering codes natin. So example lang engineering code natin dito sa structural engineering, we have the National Structural Code of the Philippines. So ito yung pinaka-latest edition, which is 2015. So ito yung parang biblia ng mga civil engineers or structural engineers in order to design our structure. Mayroong iba't ibang formulas dito na nakalagay dito sa code. That formulas are all based from from the subject na strength of materials. So kaya very important itong subject. Ngayon, let's review the statics of rigid bodies sa subject. We have loads kasi na tinatawag, and we have different loads. So we have concentrated loads and distributed loads na usually nakikita natin sa statics. So for example, ang concentrated load, let's say we have a simple beam here. So this is a pin support and roller support. This is a simple beam. And we have this concentrated load. So yan yung itsura niya. And yung unit niya, for metric, we have newtons. And for English, we have pounds. So yung concentrated load natin, nag-act lang siya sa single point in our structure or anybody. So just like this figure. And for distributed loads naman, just like this figure, yung unit naman niya for this figure, that is newton per meter for metric. Or for English, that is pounds per foot for linear load. But sometimes kasi yung distributed load natin, pwedeng distributed siya by area. So ito by line, kaya linear load siya. So ito naman na figure, this is distributed along the area. Kaya yung unit niya, pwedeng newton per square meter for metric, or for English unit naman, that is pounds per square foot. So both yan, distributed load. Pero kadalasan for 2D, yung ginagamit natin for, syempre, for beams is itong naka-linear linear distributed loads, or naka-newton per meter, or naka-pounds per foot. So ito naman, kadalasan ginagamit ito pag nag-design na tayo ng structure. So next, kailangan natin i-review sa statics is we have the support reactions. So basically, ito yung mga gamit na gamit natin sa statics, kahit hanggang sa structural theory, hanggang sa pag-design. So we have roller support, pin support, and fixed support. So for example, ng roll support, for example, this is the beam and this is the support for our left end. So this is the roller support. And para ma-solve natin yung reaction dyan, always perpendicular sa surface niya and isa lang. So always isang anon lang pag roller support. But for our pin support naman, ito yun naman yung ideal support niya or ideal picture. And this our unknowns natin for our pin support. So we have two unknowns. So we have vertical and horizontal. So basta tatandaan nyo dito na yung surface ng pin support natin, meron dyang perpendicular lagi na reaction and parallel. So basta dalawa lagi. But for our fixed support naman natin, just like this figure naman, or for in this case, that is a cantilever beam. So kung fixed support dito, tapos dito free end. So dito naman, yung pag sinolve natin yung reactions dyan, we have three reactions for our fixed support. So always dyan, meron tayong vertical lagi, meron tayong horizontal lagi, and meron tayong moment reaction na yung direction niya is ganyan, always downward. Kung baliktad yung fixed support natin sa kabila, so yung direction naman niya is clockwise. Dito kasi counter siya eh. Basta in this case, for fixed supports natin, laging tatlo yung reaction dyan. So yan yung mga kailangan natin isaulo or balikan sa statics natin na gagamitin natin din dito sa strength of materials or mechanics of materials. And last na kailangan natin i-review for statics is the equations of equilibrium. Kasi dito, just like statics, dapat yung summation of moments natin and summation of forces should be equal to zero. Or ibig sabihin yun, the resultant force or moment should be equal to zero. Kasi pag hindi tayo nag-zero yung summation natin or resultant natin, ibig sabihin, there will be an acceleration. This is not statics na or strength. That will be dynamics na of rigid bodies. So there will be an acceleration for this subject na. Kaya iniiwasan natin yung acceleration or motion of our structures. So we need to satisfy the equation na equations of equilibrium. So for 3D guys, ito yung equations na ginagamit natin. So summation of moment at the x, y, and z axis. And for summation of forces, iniquitin natin sa 0 for x, y, and z axis. So these are for 3D structures. But for 2D structures na ginagamit, nagamit natin, ito lang naman yung usually na ginagamit natin. Na yung summation of forces at x-axis is equal to 0, summation of forces at y-axis is equal to 0, and summation of moment about an reference is equal to 0. So usually, ito yung ginagamit natin na equations of equilibrium for 2D structures. So yun lang naman yung kailangan natin i-review for statics. And that's it guys. Thank you very much for listening. This is Engineer Jack and have a good day.